Welcome to the video on slope. The best way to use this video is to watch with your notebook ready to take notes while I'm teaching. Pause the video often if you need to get the notes down or do a problem again on your own. Every time the video arrives at a you try, pause and then attempt the problem. Press play and the solutions will appear along with your work. In this video, we're going to cover the following topics. One common thing is, what is slope? So when we talk about slope, we're talking about the steepness of a line. So think about when you are climbing up a hill and it's really, really difficult, and that would be a very steep hill. Maybe it's something like this. Or if you're climbing up a pretty flat, you would say it doesn't have much steepness. That is slope. When you describe going down a slide, and it's really steep, or if it's kind of flat, it's not very steep, that's all slope. So one thing we need to make clear is while we read English from left to right, we also read graphs from left to right. So when we're looking at a graph today, I'll remind you that we always start in the leftmost corner and move in this direction. There are four kinds of slope. We've got positive slope, negative slope, zero slope, and an undefined slope. Let's take a look at these real world pictures. You can see that the truck is moving up. You can see that this person is falling down. You can see that this water is very flat. The slope is zero. And you can see that this cliff is a vertical line. We call that an undefined slope. Here's another image with those arrows on it. So given the lines here, we're going to determine if the slope is positive, negative, zero, or undefined. Remember that we're always going to read from left to right. So we're always starting on this side of the graph. So we're basically going to see where we get on at this point. So we kind of look, I don't see anything, I don't see anything. Oh, there we go. And from here, I'm going up. So this is positive. We always start on the left-hand side of the graph. Right here, I see something and then I move down. The slope is negative. Always starting on that left-hand side, I hop on right there and this slope is flat. That slope is zero. And again, we get on this side. See if you can figure out what the slope is. The slope is negative. Go ahead and pause the screen. Take a moment to try these problems. Unpause it when you're ready to see the answers. How'd you do? If you have any questions, please feel free to make a discussion board. Let's continue. How could we determine a slope when we're given a graph? When we're calculating slope from a graph, we always use the letter M to represent slope. And we're counting the rise over the run, or how much we go up or down over how much we go right or left. How do we find slope from a graph? Well, to find slope, you need to have two points on the line. You can pick any two points. Just make sure that wherever they are, they're hitting in between those corners so you can get nice whole numbers. You pick any point that you want to start and you say, okay, do I need to count up or do I need to count down to get to the next point? That number becomes your numerator. Once you get up or down, then you count right or left and that number becomes your denominator. Always make sure to simplify your fraction when appropriate. Let's give it a try. So to find the slope of the line, notice that they already have two points on here. So I, again, am always reading from left to right, so I'm always starting at that leftmost point. So this leftmost point, let's see, how can we get to that next point? Do we need to go up or do we need to go down? In this case, we need to go up. We go up 1, 2. So the rise is a positive 2. Then from this point, do we need to go left or do we need to go right? To the right, 1, 2, 3. The run is a positive 3. So we always use the letter M for slope. Rise 2/3. We cannot simplify that anymore. So that is the slope of the line. Again, to find the slope, we need two points. I always pick the leftmost point, but it actually doesn't matter. So from this point, we need to know, do we go up or down? Because we're trying to find the rise. To get to this point, we need to go down. We go down 1, 2, 3, 4. So our rise is -4. From this point, do we need to go left or to the right? We'll go to the right, +1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Our run is +5. So our slope is -4/5. And those numbers don't have any common factors, so we are done. We'll do two more together. So find the slope of this line. So we've got our 2 points. You might notice, hey, that line is flat. Gee, I can't remember if that's zero or undefined. Well, let's take a look. To get to this next point, so I'm starting from left to right, do I need to go up or down? I actually don't need to go anywhere, so my rise is zero. I don't need to go up or down. It's on the same line. But I run +1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So my slope is 0/5. When I type that into the calculator, I get 0. The slope in this case is 0. Last one together. Find the slope of this line. So we're calculating from left to right. We're finding, all right, there's a point there, there's a point there. And I start at this point here, and I say up or down. My rise would be -1, 2, 3. And I run 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. +5, because I went to the right. So my slope is -3/5. You've got 3 examples to try here. Pause the video so that you can give yourself a minute to give them a try. Press play when you're ready to see the solutions in the work. See how you did? Check your answers. And then we'll move on. Now, what if I just give you 2 ordered pairs and I don't give you the graph? Now, you could certainly graph it if you wanted to, but we're going to introduce a formula so that we don't have to graph it every time. When you're given 2 points, you use the formula m equals y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. You'll see me in the videos always start the formula like this. This is the best way not to drop any negatives. So let's give it a shot. We're going to do 4 examples together. So find the slope of the line that goes through these points. I always like to label the points x, y, and then x, y. Then I go through and label, hey, that's the first ordered pair, and that's the second ordered pair. I also always write the slope formula, m equals y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Then I always draw the fraction bar, and I make 2 subtraction symbols so that I don't drop any negatives. For y2, I have 7. For y1, I have 2. For x2, 7. x1, 1. I still draw that fraction bar first. Remember, order of operations, we're going to do the top first. 7 minus 2 is 5. 7 minus 1 is 6. They don't have any common factors, so the slope is 5/6. Let's look at another one, finding the slope of the line that goes through these 2 points. The first thing I do is label them xy, xy. Then I go first ordered pair, second ordered pair. Then I start writing my formula, m equals y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. And then I always draw a fraction bar and my 2 subtraction symbols so that I don't accidentally drop a negative. So we'll start with y2. y2 is 4, y1 is 0, x2 is 3, now here we have a negative. Be super careful, you have to put that negative in. Draw that fraction bar, 4 minus 0, we get 4, 3 minus negative 5, that becomes 8. Now, these do have a common factor, you can type them in your calculator, or you could say, oh, they both have a common factor of 4. When I divide the top by 4, I get 1. When I divide the bottom by 4, I get 2. m equals 1/2. Feel free to skip ahead to the U try or stay with me for 2 more examples. We're finding the slope of the line that goes through the points. We've got our ordered pair x, y, x, y. We've got 1 first ordered pair, 2 second ordered pair. I always, no matter what, write my formula y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. And I always start with my fraction bar and my two subtraction symbols. y2 is 8. y1, be super careful with that negative, is negative 2. x2 is 5, and x1 is also 5. Something interesting is going to happen here. We get 10 over 0. Now, this is not equal to 0. Go ahead, type this in your calculator. You should get the word error. When you see the word error, we're not allowed to divide by 0. So this is undefined. This is that vertical line, that cliff's edge. Last one together. We're finding the slope of the line that goes through the points. We've got xy, xy, first ordered pair, second ordered pair. Always starting with that formula, y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Always doing that fraction bar and those subtraction symbols first. y2 is 3, y2 is 3, y1 is 1, x2 is negative 5, x1 is 3, 3 minus 1 is 2 over negative 8. Now they do have a common factor, they both can be divided by 2, 2 divided by 2 is 1, negative 8 divided by 2 is negative 4, the slope here is negative 1/4. Go ahead and pause the video here at this U try. Give all 5 of these a chance and then press play when you're ready to see the answers and my work. There you go. Check over your answers, and that concludes the video on slope.